Cinema has become one of the most prominent forms of entertainment since its inception in the late 19th century. It has attracted an extremely wide and diverse audience and has since become one of the most profitable industry. Today, movie theaters are everywhere in Indonesia. According to their website, the largest Indonesian movie theater, Cinema 21, has approximately 1,003 theaters in 43 different cities all over the nation. Such huge success have spawned numerous accusations about them monopolizing the film industry market. Being a movie theater franchise, they can choose to show any movie they want. In order to maximize profit, of course they would choose films that they think would be most profitable. As such, a lot of movies that do not attract commercial appeal is more likely to be ignored by them. As a response to this phenomena, people have tried to make alternative movie theaters, a proper vessel for movies with non-mainstream appeal, such as independently produced movies. One such place is Kinosaurus, located in Kemang, South Jakarta.
Kinosaurus itu kan mulai berdiri mulai tanggal 9 Desember 2015, didirikan oleh 3 filmmaker. Pertama ada namanya Miski Taurisia yang sering dipanggil Dede, kedua ada Edwin, ketiga Edi. Jadi tujuan mereka bertiga untuk bikin Kinosaurus itu awalnya karena mereka melihat variasi kebutuhan orang penonton film di Indonesia itu terbatas. Kalau kita ngomong akses untuk nonton film di layar pribadi, mungkin bisa nonton film apa aja. Namun kalau di bioskop, orang terbatas banget. Karena metode atau model bioskop kita saat ini yaitu kayak cineplex gitu kan. Cineplex itu artinya suatu tempat yang besar. Tempat yang besar sehingga mereka membutuhkan film-film yang penontonnya juga banyak. Otomatis mereka cuma tidak memberikan variasi-variasi film-film untuk penggemar film yang ada di Indonesia sendiri. Maka dari itu, Edwin, Dede, dan Edi mencoba untuk membuat satu pilot project yang namanya Kinosaurus agar kita bisa mengisi variasi-variasi orang untuk nonton film di sini. Film-film dari genre-genre apapun bisa kita masukin di sini, dari Indonesia maupun seluruh dunia bisa kita masukin di sini.
In this video, we will analyze Kinosaurus as a place for alternative moviegoers and what other cultural impacts that it might imply.
Itu pertanyaan yang menurut gue sama kayak nanya seberapa penting imajinasi untuk orang Indonesia gitu. Seberapa penting lo punya referensi. Seberapa penting lo punya ya apapun itu nasionalisme, apapun identitas gitu. Karena bioskop alternatif atau kanal untuk komunitas ketemu dan nonton bareng dan diskusi bareng itu kan sebenarnya kan kanal dialog ya, dan dialog tuh sesuatu yang Indonesia nggak biasa gitu. Orang-orangnya kurang apa namanya nggak tahu caranya diskusi yang baik, nggak tahu caranya berargumen yang baik gitu, yang konstruktif yang bisa membangun gitu. Nah artinya kita memang butuh kanal-kanal, kita butuh tempat-tempat buat berkumpul, menonton bareng, berdiskusi tentang itu gitu. Nah yang sekarang ada kan infrastrukturnya kurang, bioskop kurang banyak, monopoli 21 jelas ada. Terus apalagi dengan semua kekurangan itu film susah diakses juga gitu karena larangan-larangan. Walaupun pemerintah sekarang cenderung lebih lembek sama aturan, tapi ormas enggak gitu, masyarakat lokal enggak. Kalau film soal Ahok bisa dilarang di mana misalnya, atau film soal something bisa dilarang di Jakarta, orang dari Indonesia Tengah ke Indonesia Timur bisa melarang film let's say 212 misalnya ditolak di Manado kemarin gitu kan. Jadi sekarang ormas yang bergerak untuk menolak film untuk diputar, bioskopnya sedikit, kanalnya enggak ada, penolakan banyak. Ya itu buat saya sih itu presiden buruk untuk demokrasi dan untuk apa ya, untuk kesatuan dan persatuan negara ini gitu.
As you can see, Kinosaurus manages to not only become a place for alternative movie goers, but also a public space for film discourse and education. After it was established as a place for alternative movie screening, people have realized the educative purposes of alternative movie theaters. Public discourse sparks in this place as film enthusiasts do not only want to watch the movie, but also to discuss the themes, the filmmaking aspect, and the cultural implications lying in the film being discussed. As such, the place has become a public space of educational content. With this in mind, the managers behind Kinosaurus gave the people facilities in order for them to discuss film, by bringing filmmakers and fellow film experts to further discuss the film being screened in Kinosaurus. We can see that over the course of a few years, there has already been a dynamic of place and space in Kinosaurus. Being such a niche place, it is inevitable that Kinosaurus attracts people with taste outside of the mainstream culture. This leads to the notion that places like Kinosaurus, with its vast array of films being screened, attracts people with different identities. What kind of identities do they attract? We know that identity comes in many different forms. One cultural expert and fellow film enthusiast has this to say.
Kalau gue lihat secara sosiologis aja gitu, tempat dia di mana, film-film kayak apa yang selama ini dia putar, sinias-sinias apa yang pernah muter film di sana gitu. Buat gue target penontonnya kan tadi udah kita ngomong ya, kelas menengah urban, pendidikan juga ya universitas gitu ya, mostly. Beberapa juga ada ekspat di Kemang gitu kan, mau nggak mau ekspat pasti lihat-lihat juga gitu. Strategi budaya yang bisa kelihatan di situ adalah yang memang bermain dalam ranah itu gitu, ranah orang-orang yang ya entah itu filmmaker atau wannabe filmmaker gitu di kota kelas menengah tadi gitu. Dan di situ buat gue karena dia di kota maka dekat juga sama modal-modal production dalam bikin film gitu, maksudnya di Jakarta. Itu sih utamanya kalau gue lihat sasaran yang bisa kelihatan sekarang gitu.
We see that due to the general inaccessibility of independent films, especially in Indonesia, Kinosaurus only attracts some specific type of identities. Most of these identities are related to social class. Kinosaurus mainly attracts people from the middle class, those who are more educated and privileged enough to access and research these kinds of movies. Furthermore, the place itself is located in Kemang, a place in which a lot of middle to upper class people live. The search for anti-mainstream movies is maybe a sign of individualism, as stated by Michelle Maffesoli about consumer culture theory and neo-tribalism. According to Maffesoli, the forces of globalization and post-industrial socio-economic transformation have significantly eroded the traditional basis of sociality and encouraged instead a dominant ethos of radical individualism oriented around a ceaseless quest for personal distinctiveness and autonomy in lifestyle choice. However, through this feeling of individualist identity, a new collective has emerged, continuing his quote, "In response to these potentially alienating and isolating conditions, consumers forge more ephemeral collective identifications and participate in rituals of solidarity that are grounded in common lifestyle interests and leisure avocations." This means that Kinosaurus, while attracting middle to upper class educated individuals, managed to create a certain collective identity and a new sense of community through the spread of independent, anti-mainstream film and film discourse. This sense of community is taken further if we count other themes Kinosaurus tackles in their film discussions. Kinosaurus have screened and made film discussions for topics that are deemed sensitive and taboo by Indonesian people, such as gay rights. Through these film discussions, they're implicitly giving space for these types of people, as said by Ari from Kinosaurus. Even in the perspective of filmmakers, they specifically choose where their films will be distributed. Some of them are ready to sacrifice mainstream appeal and less income just to generate public discourse among these kinds of film enthusiasts that places like Kinosaurus are trying to attract. To conclude, Kinosaurus has evolved not only as a place for alternative movie screening, but also as a place for public discourse regarding alternative films. As a result, it has attracted people with many different identities and created a new sense of community and a collective purpose.